Hello and welcome to The Real Deal. Today we're talking about one of the most anticipated films of the year, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes.
That's right, it's set 10 years after the rise of the Planet of the Apes and sees a band of human survivors resurface to threaten Caesar's growing nation of genetically evolved apes. Our review of this sequel coming right up after the trailer.
War, it's not what you want. There must be another way.
So, this is a big one. A little bit. Amon, what is it all about?
Yeah, so it's takes place 10 years after Rise of the Planet of the Apes. And it actually begins very chilling fashion because if you remember at the end of Rise, they show the beginnings of the simian flu spreading throughout the world, and they begin the film like that. But Caesar's basically become king of an ape colony, and you can really see how they've grown into, you know, they're talking a little bit more than they did at the end of the last one, and they've really grown. But at the same time, you've got these band of human survivors, and they come across, or one of those humans comes across apes and shoots one of them, and that's how
it all kicks off.
It all kicks off.
It really does.
It is exceptional.
Really?
I love this film. I mean, I think firstly you have to talk about the effects. The CGI in Rise of the Planet of the Apes was fantastic. In this one, it's even better.
Did you see it in IMAX or did you see it in
I did
normal?
Not see it in IMAX, but seeing it, I'll definitely recommend seeing this one in IMAX for sure. It will be insane. I saw it at the Odeon.
Odeon.
What is Odeon? Terrible time. And that did the job. It was fantastic. Loved it.
Okay, good. And Andy Serkis is back. We love Andy Serkis, don't we?
Fantastic performance. I mean, a lot of people have been saying that he deserves an Oscar. I'm not too sure about that argument because...
Well, not specifically for this film, but I think the whole kind of... The fact that, yes, he's doing motion capture, but he's still acting as
I'm not denying it. I mean, I think it's the perfect marriage between motion capture and acting. But to say Oscar Andy Serkis would be to... It's just, there's so much CGI, and it's just a perfect marriage, as I say. So compare that to an all-human performance. And it is fantastic performance. He really sees as a really full character that he brings to life. And it's very interesting because he's got Caesar's relationship with his son. It's very interesting. Caesar's relationship with his wife and his younger kid and... with the human leaders as well. This film is so complex.
Right.
It's not black and white, apes are the good guys, humans are the bad guys. There's good guys and bad guys on both sides. And that's what makes it interesting. That's where all the complexity comes narratively. And there's a lot of social issues.
And politics
intertwined
and stuff.
With all that as well. So
that's interesting.
Great.
I mean, it's massive. There's blockbuster season right now. You know, we're in the thick of it. Mm. We've got Transformers out. This has just crushed Transformers in the States.
Yes.
And is that right?
Yes. I mean, as you all know, if you've seen the Transformers review, which we did, which you should have seen already. If you haven't, make sure you see after this one. I liked it, but this is on a whole nother level when it comes to
Why?
Blockbuster. Why? Because the narrative is much stronger.
Okay.
In a simple sense. I mean, I think, even saying that, the action is still fantastic. There's not as much action as it is in Transformers. I don't think there's going to be any film this year which has as much action as there is in Transformers. To put it
it's like 2.5 hours.
The action when it comes is fantastic. There's a shot when they're like a full-scale apes versus humans battle. And there's a shot of a tank which is rotating like 360 degrees. It's incredible directing.
Right.
I went whoa to myself when I saw it. It was fantastic. And Optimus Prime riding a robot dragon is badass. Seeing an ape on a horse firing guns, twin guns like this, is just as badass as Optimus Prime. So, I like that too.
And I mean, clearly, I'm getting the gist that you might like it
a little bit.
Are there any bad points about this film?
I don't think so. I mean, at one point I was thinking, because Gary Oldman is in this film, and at one point I was thinking that he was a little bit underused, but just as I was about to write that in my notes, he came back, and he came back. His character is very interesting as well, because, again, he's not an out-and-out villain. I mean, if you're going to label anybody a villain, than it would be Koba, who is one of the apes in okay. Caesar's colony. But Gary Oldman's character is very interesting because there's a scene, well, I'm not going to spoil it, but you really empathize with his character. You empathize with a lot of people on both the apes and the human side, and that's what makes it so great.
Okay, well, give us the real deal on this film. I'm pretty sure I know the answer, but give us your star rating.
Yeah, well, star rating, I'm going to 4 5 stars on this.
Wow!
I know that I give Boyhood 5 stars as well, but recently.
It's just a 5-star summer.
But this is very, very deserving of it. Highly recommended that go see it.
It's nice to see that a blockbuster gets 5 stars.
Yes, it deserves it for sure.
We don't mean any harm!
So that was the real review on Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, but we want to know what your favourite Andy Serkis mocap performance is so far, and by mocap, I do mean motion capture, not some weird cap thing. So Amon, he's done a lot. What's your favourite?
I'm going to go with Caesar in this film, actually.
Oh, how predictable.
No, he is fantastic in this film. It really brings Caesar to life. And you can really see, because the technology has advanced so much now, you can really see more of the nuances in his performance in The King Ape. So Caesar is
okay.
Is my
well, it's his best performance to date. However, I reckon it's got to be the performance that made him and brought him to being a household name. It's got to be Gollum from, you know, The Hobbit and all that other fantasy stuff. Anyway.
Be sure to let us know what you think on Twitter @TheRealFilmShow and check out our blog, TheRealDealOnFilm.com. See you next time.